Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to design your own striking custom modernist logo with interlocking initials. The way the letters interlock will depend on how each letter in the pair relate to each other. Ultimately, you can decide the best way to position and interlock them once your letters are side by side. The font we'll be using is called Happy Killer. You can download it from the link I provided, located in the video description or project files. If you're not sure how to install fonts, watch my tutorial on how to do this. I provided that link as well. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl-N on Windows or Command-N on a Mac. Make the width and the height 870 pixels each, with a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. Go to View and make sure Rulers and Snap are checked. If they're not, just click on them. Once you install Happy Killer, open your Horizontal Type Tool and open the font. Make the size 220 points, None for the anti-alias, and Left Alignment. Click on the color box and pick a color. I'll choose a medium blue, 567 AFF. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. Type the first letter of your name. Open your Move tool and drag the letter to the left. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Double-click on the large T of the copy and type the first letter of your last name. Double-click it again and click the color box at the top. Pick a different color for the second letter. I'll choose a coral color, 19C1AB. Open your Move tool and position the second letter ultimately where you'd like it to interlock with the first letter. Because each letter has its own unique shape, determining where they interlock is a matter of personal choice. My only advice is to position the second letter either flush with the bottom of the first letter or below it. Notice the first letter that you typed is positioned in the Layers panel below the second letter that you typed. Ctrl-click or Command-click on the large T of the first letter that you typed to make a selection of its shape. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer, which is your second initial. Invert the layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command-I. In this example, I want to interlock the letters here, so I need to hide this area of the letter P to reveal the letter M behind it. The same will apply to your letters. To do this, open your Pencil tool and make the size anywhere between 40 to 60 pixels and make the hardness 100%. Press the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open your brush panel. Make sure the only setting that's checked is smoothing. To close the panel, press F5 again. Go to the area that you want the letters to interlock and brush over it. Click on the ruler at the top and drag down a guideline until it snaps to the bottom of the second letter. If you don't see it, press Ctrl or Command H. Click on the left ruler and drag out another guideline until it snaps to the right edge of your second letter. Make your first letter active and drag out guidelines to the top and left side of the letter. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool, go to the top left corner of the guidelines, and drag out a selection to the bottom right corner. We'll fill it with black. To do this, press D on your keyboard to revert the foreground and background colors to black and white respectively, and then press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill it with the foreground color. Delete the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command D and hide the guidelines by pressing Ctrl or Command H. We're ready to add your full name under your initials. Press T to open your Type Tool and left click on the bottom of your document. Lower the point size to 20 and click on the color box. Left-click on the second letter to pick up its color and click OK. Type out your full name. Highlight your last name, click on the color box, and left-click on the first letter to pick up its color. Open your Move tool and drag the text to the left edge and bottom of your first letter. Open your Transform tool and press and hold Shift as you drag out its lower right corner until it's flush with the right edge of the shape above it. Then press Enter or Return. If there's a little space between your name and the shapes above it, press the up arrow key on your keyboard. Make the black shape active and make a copy of it. I'll open up the Layers panel so we can see all the layers. Temporarily reduce the opacity of the square copy to 50%. Open your Transform tool, go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift and Alt on Windows, or Shift and Option on a Mac, as you drag it out approximately this much. Go to the top middle, and when you see a vertical double arrow, drag it up the same distance as the sides are from the inside shapes. Go to the bottom middle, and drag it down the same distance below your name. Then, press Enter or Return. Increase its opacity to 100%, and reduce its fill to 0. Double-click on the square copy to open its layer style window. Click Stroke. The position is inside, and the size is 14 pixels. To move the bottom of the black frame so it touches the bottom of your text, open your Transform tool, go to the bottom middle, and drag it up. Then, press Enter or Return. To center the entire logo on your document, make the bottom square active and Shift-click on the top layer to highlight all the layers in between. Then, press Ctrl or Command-G to place all the layers into a folder. Press Ctrl or Command-A and click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then delete the selection. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.